I'm Tony Dungy, and I want to welcome you to the 2023 CHRIStal Ball. You're there tonight to honor a great friend of mine, Rich McKay, who I got to know 25 years ago when he was the general manager of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. We worked together, and our goal was to bring Tampa a Super Bowl, but also to make Tampa a better place to live. And I know Rich and his wife, Karen, and their entire family has brought that same attitude to Atlanta and done just a tremendous job. So thank you for being there to honor him. I hope you have a great night, and also help the Chris 180 organization. This is a tremendous group that helps people of all ages in the Atlanta metropolitan area. So have a great time tonight. Enjoy the food, the fellowship, the fun, the dancing, but most of all, get your wallets ready to support this wonderful organization. And let's do what we can to help make Atlanta a better place to live.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our co-chairs for the CHRIStal Ball, Lori Chenault, April Estes, and Cyril Turner.
Hi, everybody. How are you today? I appreciate your attention, and we're getting ready to go on the show here. So welcome to the 2023 CHRIStal Ball. Thank you for joining us. To those who are attending this event for the first time, a special welcome to you and a promise that this will be an unforgettable evening. Our hope is that you will leave with a profound understanding of the immense impact Chris 180 and the role you can play in helping people change the direction of their lives. The mission of Chris 180 is to heal children, strengthen families, and build community. Through our extensive range of programs, we work to foster a sense of belonging and support by providing children, adults, and families with high-quality, trauma-informed mental health services and the support they need to build resilience. As you settle into the program, I want you to remember for years, your years as a teenager and a young adult, those formative times were exciting, awkward, and confusing, and humiliating. The movies, The Breakfast Club and 16 Candles only touch on some of those awkward moments. What so many of us have, though, is the realization that our network of growth got us through it. A parent, teacher, mentor, coach, family member, or friend helps support. Tonight, we are going to explore how Chris 180 supports kids who, for one reason or another, but at no fault of their own, either have those trusted relationships or need additional support to overcome difficult circumstances beyond their control. CHRIS 180 is the network, the foundation, the rock that helps get folks through tough and very difficult times of their life to reaching their full potential. So at this point, I'd like to turn your attention to the video.
I got a letter from a mom whose family we worked with once, and she said, "We were so mired down in difficulties, we couldn't see a way out." And so I think that's what we do at Chris 180. We acknowledge the difficulty, we don't minimize it, and we help people find a way through and out.
Them couple of days that I slept in a car with my kids, showed me that there is a God. Because you know, sometimes our family can't help us. Sometimes it takes strangers, complete strangers, to actually give us hope and give us encouragement, like it's gonna be okay. And that's all I received through Chris 180 throughout this entire time, like it's gonna be okay. Especially with Mr. James, he made sure that he was there, he was supportive.
All of our services are really reaching out to those people who were underserved and looking at context, because context matters. We all come to where we are because of our past experiences and because of the people who were in our lives who either believed in us or didn't. all of us want to be accepted for who we are, where we are. And that's where healing can begin.
Our 25-year-old son came to us and told us he was trans and he was beginning his transition. Almost immediately, I said to myself, we need help. My family needs help. I need help. My wife needs help. Where would I go? And it took a second to think. There's this organization that I've been a part of for years. It was just amazing.
Everyone on the team, from the people in the counting to the people who do the direct service, understands their piece in accomplishing the mission of healing children, strengthening families, and building community.
Thank you for just being my little angels and coming to help me and bless me.
Thank you for what you do and the impact that you have on so many lives.
I couldn't be more proud of the work that everyone does and the level of commitment everyone has. We're going to make the world a better place.
As we celebrate the incredible work of Chris 180, tonight we are proud to honor our friend from a long time, Rich McKay. Rich, your leadership, both professional and as an advocate for Chris 180, sets an inspiring example for so many of us to follow. Thank you, Rich. Thanks to your dedication and his incredible wife, Taryn, and each one of you, Chris 180 remains innovative, continuously creating new ways to reach those in need. 41 years ago, we were founded with the purpose of recognizing gaps in the community and filling them, and that remains our daily commitment. Chris 180 is a groundbreaking organization that addresses ongoing and emerging community needs. Mental health is on every agenda these days. Chris 180 has recognized its importance and provided therapeutic services and training since the beginning. This organization, for over 40 years, offers thought leadership, facilitators to train for literally thousands across the metro area.
We could not do this without your support, and we extend a heartfelt gratitude to our community supporters, especially our presenting sponsor, Delta Airlines, as well as our champion sponsors. Yes. As well as our champion sponsors, Cox Enterprise, the Arthur M. Blank Family Foundation, and Georgia Pacific. Thank you also to our protector and advocate sponsors, premier patrons and patrons, whose names are displayed on the screen. A special thanks goes out to our president and CEO, Kathy Colbinson, the dedicated Chris 180 team, and every board and advisory council member. Your unwavering commitment to this vital mission is honorable and commendable. As we continue the festivities, please take part in the silent auction and the Louis Vuitton purse. Share your experiences on social media using the hashtag CHRISTALBALL23 and get ready for a fantastic time with one of our favorite auctioneers, Trey Morris. And now, please help me welcome our presenting Delta Airlines sponsor and a Chris 180 board member, Pascal Lewis, Vice President of Omnichannel Strategy and Design.
So April, I appreciate the introduction and want to acknowledge your, along with Lori and Cyril's, outstanding effort in organizing this wonderful event. which will raise so much needed funds for CHRIST 180. On behalf of Delta Airlines and our 90,000 employees, we extend a warm greeting to everyone present here. At Delta, giving back is ingrained in our culture. We are committed to being strong partners in the communities where we live, work, and serve, starting with our hometown. Each year, our employees contribute thousands of volunteer hours to hosts of causes across the globe, aiming to make a positive difference in the world. We are proud to be actively involved in making our Atlanta community a better place. It is with a great honor to partner with CHRIST 180, an organization that has a critical, consistent, and growing impact on those that need it most. And yes, I remember my teenage years, and I'm grateful I got through them. Yeah, and that CHRIST 180 is here to help young people and their families who need additional support. For me, I mean, I know I look kind of big now, but growing up, I was a skinny, awkward, some may even call nerdy kid, and there were so many times where having someone to talk through the challenges would have helped me navigate middle school, high school quite a bit better. So I am very personally supportive of the people, particularly the people and the work that CHRIST 180 does. And with that, it is my honor to welcome one of the incredible young people to offer us a bit of her experience and words of gratitude. Ladies and gentlemen, please do a warm round of applause in welcoming Hazel to the stage. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I am 14 years old and I just started ninth grade. I want to share why I'm grateful for CHRIST 180. I have always been a kind and energetic and happy person. You may remember or even see it in your kids that mood can change a lot when you're my age. Fighting with your parents is a normal thing during the teenage years, and that was happening. Everything changed when I lost a very special friend to suicide last year. I felt like my problems grew and grew. In the months after his death, I went from being a happy person to becoming sad, feeling depressed, and I became withdrawn from my family. I cried a lot, and I was mean to the people around me, which wasn't like me. I didn't know how to change, but I knew I needed help. My mother knew something was wrong, and she knew she had to figure out how to help. But in the Hispanic culture, needing a therapist or someone to talk to is seen as a bad thing. I am lucky. My mother is strong and wasn't scared to get me what I needed. She reached out to a friend who knew one of the therapists at CHRIST 180's Lawrenceville office, Ms. Gigi, who welcomed us with open arms and kindness. I had no idea what to expect, but she was easy to speak to. She spoke Spanish to my parents and even Spanglish to me. It was such a relief to know that she could talk to us and understand our culture because she was one of us. She knew before we walked in that this would be hard for everyone and likely hard for my father, a strong Hispanic man who supports our family. It was such a relief to be able to talk about what happened and have a real conversation about it. I just recently learned that Ms. Gigi also worked with my mother and father to make sure that we were a whole family again. I am still working with Ms. Gigi and expect to for a very long time because therapy is important. I am back to being me, happy about friends and school. My mother is so relieved, and my father, even though he may not be into therapy like the rest of us, has made some really big changes. He brightened the house with new paint because he wanted me to have a more cheerful and happy environment. He loves family time and always makes us a priority. And none of this would have been possible without CHRIST 180. My sadness and grief over my friend will always be there. But however, there has been so many positives for me and my entire family with the help of CHRIST 180. I am so grateful that they are literally down the street from my house. I am grateful to know how to ask for what I need and express my emotions. CHRIST 180 is a gift to my family, and I see it as a gift to the Hispanic community. One person, one family at a time, my community can get even better by talking and healing. CHRIStal 180 is making it happen, and for that, I am grateful. Thank you.
Come on, Atlanta, make some noise up here. Come on. What's wrong with this thing? What an incredible story. Hazel, thank you for sharing your courageous journey with us. We are so lucky to have her here. I want to just tell you real quick. Mom and Dad are here. Miss Gigi are here. Will you show them some love one more time, Atlanta? Come on. Incredible. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's good to be back. I just got to ask, how many people have been a part of this event in the past? You have been a part of CHRIStal 180, this very event. Show me your hands. Incredible. Give yourselves a round of applause. Yes. How many new people do we have? Incredible. And I got some people that don't know. You don't remember. I understand. There's a lot of people. What do you say today, whether you're new or old, we raised more money than we've ever had before for CHRIStal 180 tonight? Well, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Trey Morris. I'm here to do just that. I'm the auctioneer for today from Murray, Kentucky. I flew all the way in here today from Nashville, Tennessee. The 2019 International Auctioneer Champion, and the only reason I'm telling you that is to tell you that I showed up this year to help raise more money than you've ever raised before. So we're going to do just that. Now, I have got an incredible live auction, two live auction items, three rules of engagement. Rule number one goes like this. There's a lot of people that know a lot of people inside this room, especially even at your table. During the live auction, there are no friends during the live auction. Put your blinders on as if you're a horse at the racetrack looking straight for the finish line. Rule number two. If you drink too much, fall asleep, I catch you scrolling through Instagram or doing anything in which you're not attentive, we will use your bid card against you. You're going to purchase something. We've already captured your credit card, so you're got. But rule number three, perhaps the most important rule of all, every time I say sold, S-O-L-D, we are changing direction, we are changing lives, we're taking someone just like Hazel and her family, and we're changing the cycle. I need a big round of applause because we're fulfilling the mission of CHRIStal 180. Every time I say sold. Now, there's a lot of people that have already had food. I need you to cheerlead. I don't know if you have a napkin at your table or what you can do to help me cheerlead just a little bit, but I need you, if you're not bidding, to help me get these items sold. Who's ready for live auction item number one? Come on. Yes. Finally getting you warmed up. Listen to this. You're going to get to explore stunning Portugal. This is an opportunity to embark on a remarkable adventure in the beautiful country of Portugal. Here's what you get. 7 nights of comfort accommodations in various locations throughout Portugal, immersing yourself in this unique charm and absolute beauty. At the count of three, I want everybody to say, wow. 1, 2, 3. You get a full-day travel excursion, dedicated travel planning. You get concierge service. This package is based on double occupancy, so it's perfect for two people that are going to be sharing a room or a bed. If you want to bring along additional guests, well, you can certainly do that. There may be some additional fees as well. Accommodation options are tailored to your preferences. How many people are going to be traveling in the next 3 years? Show me your hands. That's everybody, in case this thing isn't working real good. Even me, we're going to be traveling in the next 3 years. Well, that's good, because you have 3 years to redeem this. You can book your package, get ready to explore the wonders of this fascinating country, Portugal. How much and how many dollars? What do you say and what do you pay? How could it be? How could it be? Never to tell me. Not gonna be never to how much? How many dollars? How could it be? Never. This is what I love about this place in Atlanta. See, sir, I haven't even said a number yet, and you've already got your card up. How much were you thinking you wanted to start this out at? I can tell you really want to go. Would you start it out for $4,000? $4,000. And now $5,000. How could it be $4,500? $5,000. $6,000. How could it be $6,000? And now to get down $7,000. How could it be $7,000? How could it be to get down? How could it be down to $7,000? How could it be down to $7,000? And now $7,000. How could it be down to $7,000? Sir, hey, sir, look at me. You haven't listened to a word that she has said all week long. I don't know why in the world you'd listen to her tonight. You want to be 6,500? And now 6,555. How could it be? How could it be? 65. And now 7. How could it be 7? And now 7,555. How could it be? Sir, it's your turn again. This is just like checkers. How could it be? 7,555. And now 7,500. How could it be? 75. How could it be? 75. How could it be? 75. Hey, how could it be? 75. Hey, how could it be? 75. How could it be? 8,000. How could it be? 8,000. Now 8. And now 8,000. How could it be? 75 is way over there. And now 8,000. How could it be? 75. Hey, how could it be? 75. How could it be? 8,000. I'm just now getting warmed up, old buddy. What you gonna do? How could it be? 75. Hey, how could it be? Day. How could it be? Day. How could it be? Day. She said no, and he's wanting to go. How could it be? Day. You love him, don't you? How could it be? Day. How could it be? Day. Take another swig of that liquid courage and give me that 8,000. How could it be? Day. 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 How could it be? $8,000 going what? How could it be? 8,000 twice. How could it be? Tell me. How could it be? You know what I'm gonna do? You know what I'm gonna do? Because I want a lot of people to go do this. I see it. Watch me. I'm going to let you go. Watch. I'm giving everybody a discount, but I'm getting it back here in just a minute. $7,000 is the ending number. I'm going to let you go, sir. Bidder number 222. You're going for $7,000. Watch this. 222 is going for $7,000. 157 is going for $7,000. Now, I want both of y'all to listen to me. I gave you a $1,000 discount, okay? That means a little bit later in the program, when we get to our fund the mission portion, I'm going to want that discount back. Amen or oh me. Everybody understand what we're talking about? I gave you a $1,000 discount, $7,000 there, $7,000 there. And sir, if you want to go, I'm going to let you go for $7,000 as well. I got a couple of these left. Would you like to go? No pressure. Anybody else would like to go? Yes. Sold. Right over here. Show me that number. What's your number? 282. We just sold another one for $7,000. That gave me thumbs up. I got one more. Does anybody else want to go? We just raised $21,000, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. So if anybody else would like to go, you can certainly let me know. If you are traveling alone and you need a guest to go with you, the auctioneer from Murray, Kentucky will certainly love to go to Portugal. Be awesome, especially in support of Chris 180. I need your attention because I've only got one live auction item left, and I will go ahead and let the cat out of the bag. I do not have multiples of this item. You must be the high bidder. This is calling all the diehard Atlanta Falcons fans. This is the moment you've been waiting for, once-in-a-lifetime experience. It's going to blow your football-loving absolute mind because I know how crazy this town gets about the Falcons. Picture yourself in the McKay's private suite at the iconic Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Four. One, two, three, four premium tickets to witness the Falcons in action at a home game in October or November. Game is to be agreed upon with the McKays. Your ultimate fan experience isn't going to stop there. Why? Because you and your friend are also going to get exclusive opportunity to see the players warm up close as you go to the pregame sideline passes. Now, that's for Falcons fans only, so don't think you're going to get the sidelines passes if you show up wearing some other team colors. I'm just going to throw that out there. It ain't going to work, okay? Now, in addition to that, you're also going to get game day parking pass to ensure that you have a hassle-free arrival. Have we got any Falcons fans here at all? And I know that you're here to support Chris 180. You have to be the high bidder on this one because I do not have multiples, ladies and gentlemen. How much? How many dollars? What do you say and what do you pay? How could it be to buy? How could it be never to tell me? How could it be never to how much? How much are you bidding back there? I haven't said a number yet. I love how eager you guys are today. How much, ma'am? What were you thinking? Are you hiding behind him? Who would give $2,000 for this? Two. And now 2, 2, 2. Now gonna be 2, 3. Now gonna be 3, 3, 3. Now gonna be 2,000, 3,000. Now gonna be 3, 3. Now gonna be 2, 3. Hit $3,000. I'm just getting warmed up, ladies and gentlemen. This is the last and final live auction item. I need to have some fun. Who give 2,500? Now gonna be 25,500. At 25,300. Now gonna be 25,300. Now gonna be 3, 3, 3. Now gonna be to get a buy. I'm gonna be $3,000 on them. I'm gonna be $3,000. I'm gonna be sir. You jumped this rabbit. Now you gotta run it. That's what they say in Kentucky. 3,000. And now 35. Now gonna be 35,500. Now gonna be 3,500. I'm gonna be net about 35,500. I'm gonna be 30. He didn't get a buy. I'm gonna be net about 35. And now 5. And now 5. I'm gonna be 35. I'm gonna be to get a buy. I'm gonna be net about 30. He didn't get a. They're gonna be net about 3,500. They're gonna be net about. And now 3,500. I'm gonna be net about 35. I'm gonna be 35. I'm gonna be to get a buy. I'm gonna be net about 3,500. You're in the lead, sir. Everybody else is out. I'm gonna be 3,500. Going what? I thought y'all said we had Falcons fans here. And now $3,500 is bid in the back. And now 4, 4, 4. I'm gonna be 35,400. I'm gonna be $4,000 on them. I'm gonna be 4,000. And now 4,500. And now 45,500. I'm gonna be 45,500. I'm gonna be 4,500. I'm gonna be 4,500. I'm gonna be net about to search. Your turn in the back. 4,500. If you bid, I can almost guarantee you we'll get you a table up closer next year. 45. How could it be 45? How could it be 45? How could it be 45 to get down 5? How could it be 45 to get 10 to get down 45? 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, Hey, $4,500, not gonna be digging a bit, $4,500 going once. Not gonna be able to get a buy, I'm gonna be that over the $4,500 going twice. Not gonna be able to get a buy, I'm gonna be that over the $4,500 third and final time, and I. All right, Atlanta, put your hands together. Sold. 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 $4,000. Hold that number up for me. You know what this gentleman just told me, and this is what I love about Atlanta, and this is why I keep coming back. He said, make it $5,000, ladies and gentlemen. Sold, 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 $5,000. Put it on bid number 175. Thank you for your support. How incredible is that? You guys having fun? You like raising money? Well, I'm going to tell you, as much fun as I am having running around this room and raising money and talking fast and interacting with all of you, what we are about to do in this room right here, right now, is the. It is the. Listen to me now. I'm going to call y'all down. It is the single most important thing that we're going to do together all night long. Now listen, at the count of three, my mama raised me not to shush anybody. I would never do that. But if you shush yourselves, I got to have your attention here real quick. So at the count of three, help me out. One, two, three. That's the other reason I love Atlanta. Watch this. This is a very special part of our program, and it's my most favorite part of our program. It's the real reason that we're actually here. I know you got dressed up. And I know everybody's looking sharp tonight. You get out on the town and you eat great food. But what we're about to do is the real reason that we all gathered here. Amen? Come on. I ain't preaching yet. Watch. We've all been giving round of applauses, but the American Sign Language way of giving a round of applause, can you show us how to do it? Two hands and a little twist. Two hands and a little twist. If I catch you and you don't have your hands up and you ain't twisting them in just a minute, you're missing why we're here. I am begging you. I am pleading with you. Please turn your undivided attention up to the stage as we welcome a very special young lady. You're going to applaud and welcome her to the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Rocia.
Thank you, Trey, and thanks to all of you for the great round of applause in ASL. I appreciate it, and I'm honored to be here to tell my story. I was born in Tanzania. I could hear at birth, and my family was also hearing. But at the age of two, I contracted meningitis and lost my hearing completely. My mom knew I would have no opportunities in Tanzania as someone who was deaf. So I went to public school, but there were no deaf schools for me there, no one to teach me sign language, no way for me to live a productive life. In fact, it might have even been dangerous for me, and she knew that. I couldn't communicate at all. Life would have been really difficult. But when I was 7 years old, my mom managed to find a way for me to come to America along with my family and siblings. We left everything with only the hope of a better life for me. We arrived in Clarkston, Georgia. I was able to start school at the Atlanta Area School for the Deaf. I was 9 years old and I quickly learned American Sign Language and English. It was great for me at school, but I still had no way to communicate with my mother and family who did not know how to use sign language. They didn't speak English, only Swahili. It was complicated and frustrating for us all. My mother was away a lot, and eventually the police were called to do a wellness check on us. We were living in pretty bad conditions, often had no power, and we were left alone a lot. I was the oldest, so I was often responsible for my siblings. There was also abuse in the home, and it was completely unstable. I know my mother wanted the best for us, but we were basically homeless. So when I was 16 years old, I, along with my siblings, were taken into DFACS custody. We were all put in foster care homes. As a teenager, that was extremely difficult. In the foster home, I continued at Atlanta Scary for the Deaf. School was the only place where I felt supported and understood. It was the only place I could communicate. My foster parents didn't know how to sign either. When I turned 18, I was in my junior year, and I was transferred to Georgia School for the Deaf. Georgia School for the Deaf is a residential school for deaf children. During the week is where I lived, and it was great. I loved it. I thrived. And I'm proud to say I was a valedictorian of my high school class. That was a happy moment, though, even though it was really scary. I had no idea what my next step would be or how I would survive on my own because I'm deaf, about to age out of foster care, and I knew that my family could not support me. I wanted to be a successful adult and go to college, and that was one more journey I had to overcome. My mother didn't bring me all the way from Tanzania not to succeed. A counselor from the residential school suggested that I visit CHRIS 180 to see if I could use that place to be where I could transition to adulthood. I came for a visit, and it was absolutely true. Look, no one there uses sign language, and I'm the only deaf person, but they were excited serving me and didn't see my deafness as a barrier to success. They provide interpreters so that I could be a part of the community, and that's exactly what is happening. A big step to becoming independent was learning how to get around on MARTA, and I learned that at CHRIS 180. I did take a few wrong buses, but now I get around like a pro. I'm pretty proud of myself. I get to go to Atlanta Technical College by bus, where I'm working towards an associate's degree in culinary arts. I plan to transfer to a 4-year college for a bachelor's degree in business, and I'm active in Future Business Leaders of America, and I have even won a few competitions. And every day I work hard in school and at CHRIS 180 to learn life skills while living on my own in a supportive community. My goal is to open a restaurant and become a business owner one day, and I know that with CHRIS 180's support, this will happen. Here's the thing. I didn't have an option other than CHRIS 180. And after the sacrifices my family made for me to get into this country, there is no way I'm going to fail. CHRIS 180 is my community now, and even if they are all people who don't sign, they have given me everything I need to feel safe, supported, and eventually ready to lead the successful and productive life that my mother envisioned for me when she made the decision to leave our country. I'm grateful to her for that, and I'll be forever grateful to CHRIS 180 for the love, support, and dedication to making me a community member. They work hard for me and each other person at Summit Trail. So thank you for the supporting them to support me. And I can't wait to be the success I know I will be. Thank you.
How incredible is that? Come on. Say thank you, Rucia, for sharing your courageous journey with us. I know that ain't easy, all the accolades that she has, but here's what I believe. I believe when she opens her restaurant, there's a room full of people right here that'll go eat at that restaurant. Yes. No way that you're going to fail, and that's because of Chris 180. What an incredible story. There's not much else I can say, ladies and gentlemen. I told you what we were about to do is the single most important thing that we do together all night long, and it most certainly is. And this is our Fund the Mission portion of the evening, to support families, children, just like Hazel, just like Rucia, and many other others that you heard tonight. We have an incredible opportunity in front of us tonight to fulfill the mission of Chris 180. So I'm going to lean on you, and I'm going to ask for your help tonight. Here's how it's going to work. I'm going to call out some very specific funding levels. When I get to a level or levels at which you would like to make a direct contribution, a tax-deductible donation, I just simply want you to slide your bid card into the air. We're going to raise more tonight than we've ever raised before. And we know that we're changing direction, and we're changing so many people's lives with this money. The committee has asked me to start at a very specific giving level. Tonight, I'm going to start in a way that we have never done before. But before I do that, I always share a quote. Sometimes they become very redundant. Sometimes I do them very frequently. But tonight, I got two quotes for you. The first is from Winston Churchill. He said, "We make a living by what we get, but we make a life by what we give." Tonight, we got an opportunity to give to something pretty special. Help these children, strengthen these families, and build our community the way it needs to be built, ladies and gentlemen. The second is from Danny Thomas. He said these words, "If you don't get nothing else from me, take this home. Success, success has nothing to do with what you gain in life or you accomplish for yourself. It's what you do for other people." And tonight we got an opportunity to do for other people. In fact, our friends Frank and Liz Blake are stepping up, and they're going to give back. They're going to do just that. We've never had this amount given at this event before, so I want you to make some noise. They were here earlier. They had to leave, but they wanted to make this gift before they left. Frank and Liz Blake have committed $20,000 to kick off our Fund the Mission tonight. That was pretty pathetic for $20,000. But luckily, we have a lot of giving levels. We got a lot of giving levels that we can celebrate. You're going to hear this question a lot, but is there anybody that will join Frank and Liz at the $20,000 giving level? Tax-deductible donation, charitable contribution. I believe there's three things you can do with your money, friends. You can spend it. We just watched that in the live auction. You can save your money, and that is boring. Or you can invest your money. And when you invest your money, you expect what? A return on your investment. I cannot think of a better return on your investment here at Chris 180 than changing and turning somebody's life around. Is there anybody else that can help us out at $20,000 real quick? Well, for the first time in the history, we have it. Big round of applause for Frank and Liz Blake. $20,000 donation. Come on. The committee asked me to start at 10. We're already above that. I want to tell you just quickly that I am from a very small town in West Kentucky called Murray, Kentucky. I have listened to crickets my whole entire life. So if you think being here close to downtown Atlanta, I don't really know where I'm at in Atlanta, just to be real honest with you. But if you think I'm scared to hear a few crickets in this room, you are wrong. So I'm just going to ask, is there anybody that could give above 10,000, perhaps 15? Anybody? You never know unless you ask. And I just got to ask. This is where the crickets come in. But see, I'm not bothered. Anybody, real quick. Well, let me ask you this. Is there anybody that can step up tonight at $10,000? Now, I got a hair trigger, too, I'll tell you. So if you flinch right now, scratch your eyebrow, you do anything, I'm turning you in. I want you to think about $10,000, how it helps provide food, utilities, transportation, and life skill sessions for 6 months for a young adult transitioning into their first apartment at our Summit Trail Apartments. Come on, is there anybody that can help me out at $10,000 tonight? This is where the committee asked me to start. Is there anybody? Real quick. Watch this. One, two, nine. Those crickets aren't so loud anymore, sir. I will say, when you make a gift from the side of the room, just like my gentleman from the back of the room earlier, it really does increase your chance of getting moved closer to the front next year. Oh, the wife made it up front. That's awesome. Thank you for your gift. $10,000 kick us off. You're going to hear this question a lot. Is there anybody else at $10,000, tax deductible, charitable contribution? Is there anybody else? Real quick. You guys are incredible. Come on, Atlanta, make some noise. Let's go. Let's go. Thank you. Thank you. Now, I told you there's a giving level for everybody here. So y'all going to have to loosen up. Bartenders, you have my permission. You can pour them a little bit stronger. If everybody needs to, go ahead and finish what you got in front of you. Our next giving level is $5,000, provides weekly life-changing therapy sessions for a year for an uninsured child or young adult. You heard Hazel talk about this earlier. Miss Gigi's here, one of the therapists. Who could step up tonight? $5,000. Charitable contribution. Thank you. Watch this. Teaching them young. Bidder number 132. I sure hope his parents are here. 132. After that, 344. God bless you. Thank you for that. 344. Watch this. 323 in the back of the room. $5,000. Come on, baby. After that, I see you. 327 with another $5,000 gift. Come on, make some noise up in here. Yes, you can celebrate. That is four. Is there anybody else? I sure really wanted one more. 25,000 sounds better than 20, doesn't it? Is there anybody else? You know, if one more person made a gift, you may inspire all the next gifts that are to come. Is there anybody else that can help us at $5,000? Watch this. 116. 116. We just raised $25,000 at the $5,000 giving level. And your gift is going to inspire all the next gifts, I guarantee. Is there anybody else at the $5,000 giving level? Real quick. You guys are awesome. Come on, really make some noise. $25,000 more. Let's go. This is where it starts getting good. This is where I need your help. If you did what I told you earlier and you finished your drink, that's going to help me a lot. Next giving level, listen to this. It's $2,500. It helps provide violence interrupters who work to help prevent the spread of violence and healing circles in neighborhoods suffering stress and chronic trauma. I want you to think about some of the fear that some of these children and some of these families are facing. All the trauma and all the violence and everything that they're exposed to, and how Chris 180 is interjecting and breaking that cycle of violence. Is there anybody that can step up tonight at $2,500? Watch this. 228. Thank you. $2,500. After that, 272. And he did it with a smile on his face. That's what I call giving joyfully right there. Watch this. 187. Half smile. There's that smile. 232, another $2,500. You guys are incredible. Is there anybody else? 155. After that, 276. Thank you very much for that. After that, your parents are here too, right? 243. Teaching them young. Dad, way to go. That's incredible. Wow. Are you raising it? 310 with a $2,500 gift. Is there anybody else? I got to talk to my recorders in the back of the room. How many is that at 2,500? Because I feel like it's 7 or 8, and that's just a weird number. That's 8? Yeah, that's a weird number. You see, if we get 2 more, that's another $25,000. And so I need 2 more gifts at 2,500. I know it's here. Watch this. Bless you. 233. That's 9. Your gift is going to help us get to that even 10. I need 1 more gift of 2,500. And I will tell you, the most we have ever raised at this giving level, 7. We broke a record at this giving level. But your gift is going to inspire number 10. I need one more. And what you also don't know about me is I will put locks and chains on the doors of this place, and we will stay the night here until I get 10. You know why you're here. And I need your help. And I hate to give up, because this number 9 gift is certainly going to inspire number 10. I need 1 more gift of 2,500. 1, 3, 4. 1, 3, 4. My guy. Thank you. We just raised another $25,000, Atlanta. Come on. Now, we have baked one heck of a cake in here, but we got to put a little icing on it. What do you say? I don't think my job is quite secured yet for 2024. The next giving level, listen to this, helps provide school supplies, something so many children take for granted, right? Take advantage of it. School supplies for 6 children in our school-based mental health program, $1,000. $1,000. Who can help us do that? There should be cards going up all over this room, Atlanta. Get them up. I'm going to start calling them from right to left. 214. After that, 283. After that, 331. After that, 265 with a smile on her face. After that, 186, tallest guy here. After that, 195, thank you. After that, 302, $1,000. After that, 177. After that, 305. After that, 200. After that, 219. After that, 261, half smile, I saw it. Watch this, 289, sharp-dressed man, thank you very much. After that, 264 with a big smile. After that, 193. Yeah, we got a lot more to watch this crazy table right here. We've already had some gifts flowing in from there. I like this table. 253, 229, $1,000 gift tonight. Watch this, 194. You looking good too, old buddy. 194. 158. 158 with a $1,000 gift. Is there anybody else that can help us? $1,000. We got a little ways to go on this one. 313. 313. Thank you for that. That's a smile. I got to ask, how many is that? Watch this. 217. 217. That's what I'm talking about. That made 21. Well, it seems like 25,000 is going to be the lucky number tonight. I need 4 more gifts of $1,000. Now, listen, I want to have a drink with you, too, and I want to celebrate and high-five and do all those things. So the quicker that you do it, the better off we're all going to be. I will say this. If I can get one person, you will inspire those last 3. Here it is. You did it. You did it. 310 is 1. I need 3 more. Y'all are snickering. Watch this. Is there anybody else that can help us? I need 3 more gifts. 3 more gifts. $1,000. Not a huge sacrifice. Watch this. We are going to get there now. 168. 168. That means I need 2 more. Make some noise in here, Atlanta. Come on. I need 2 more. 2. 117. I need 1 more gift. 5, 6, we just raised another $25,000. Make some noise up in here. Woo. I got cold chills. Which one of y'all was snickering? I know. This one? Trouble. Cut her off. You guys are incredible. I told you there's a giving level for every single person that's here. I got just a few left. Our next giving level is $500, which helps provide essential resources like shoes, clothes, raincoats, MARTA cards for one of our youth who are experiencing homelessness. $500 goes a long way with Chris 180. Help us out. 121 gives again. Already made one gift, and they just gave again in our Fund the Mission. 121, bless you. After that, 250. After that, 293. After that, 127. I see you back there. After that, 263. After that, 303. Next up, I see that smile, 280. After that, 309 at the rowdy table. After that, 216. Next up, 257. After that, 325. There it is. After that, 225. After that, 133, sharp dressed man. After that, 308. Thank you for that $500 gift. Next up, 342. 170. 115. 353. 354. 195. 238, 105, and I mean, they're pulled up at the bar. After that, 184. After that, 211. Next up, 316. Thank you for that gift. After that, watch this, 340 with another $500 gift. I didn't get that number back there. 326 with another $500 donation. You guys are incredible. Is there anybody else that can help us out? $500. I see you. 191. 191. Anybody else? I appreciate that round of applause. You're the only one clapping right then, buddy. It's the only one. Come on, people. Make some noise. Is that another 500? And this gentleman, he has given once, and he's going to give again. Let me see that number one more time. 228. Now, I could never pull that coat off, sir, but you pull it off nicely. 167. 167, another 500. After that, 185. Whoever got hired on these wands this year, we're either going to hire you back or we're going to turn in your applications to the state and road department, because you guys are incredible. Incredible. Anybody else? Anybody else? Come on, big round of applause, $500. All right, then. I got two giving levels left. I am not making light of this whatsoever. I want to just share, first and foremost, $250 provides GED and college prep for one youth who is aged out of foster care. $250. Bidder number 103. Thank you. After that, 140. Thank you. After that, 274. After that, 141. Thank you. After that, 298. After that, 299. After that, 131. Thank you for that $250 gift. Next up, 100. Nicely done back there. After that, 281. After that, 339. Thank you for your help tonight. After that, 120. 120. Next up, 145. After that, 239. And he helped me during the live auction as well. Thank you for that. After this, 241. After that, I like that table right there. I just want y'all to know. After that, 106. Next up, 359. After that, 271. After that, 269. After that, 190. I see you, little buddy. I see you. 132 with another $250 gift. After that, 206. After that, 208. Is there anybody else? $250. We just need two more. Is that what you're trying to tell me? Where are we at? We have 22. Watch this. 338. Thank you. After that, 348. Is there another one? 311. That light gets me every time. 311. Thank you for that. Keep it moving. How many is that? 25 gifts? 25 gifts at $250. Is there anybody else that can step up and help us out? Oh, I see you. 118. 118. Yes, you could give a round of applause. That's 26. Is there anybody else, real quick? $250. I got to have your attention one more time because of the back of the room. So at the count of three, help me. I'd never shush you, but I need you to do it. One, two, three. One more time for the people in the back. One, two, three. You guys are incredible, and we are breaking records in every single way here tonight. I have one giving level left, and that giving level is $100. Helps provide a full psychiatric assessment for youth to start their journey of healing, just to come in, get assessed, and start the journey at Chris 180. Maybe you've already given, but maybe, just maybe, you can give again. And she started me off right off the bat, 240. Here's what I want you to think about. Listen to me. I want you to think about all those times on Sunday Chick-fil-A was closed and you was trying to go there. You would have spent $100. There should be cards going up everywhere. I'm looking for a table in which everybody at the table will say, Trey, I'll give $100. There should be cards going up all over the place. Hurry, hurry, hurry. 205. After that, watch this crazy table back there. Watch this. They kicked me off. They start. Watch this. 218, 322, 171. And this lovely lady kicked it all off. 100% participation at this table, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. 203 with a $100 gift. 321, thank you. After that, thank you, buddy. 132, $100. 291. After that, 284. After that, 103. After that, I'm going to split y'all up next year. 159. After that, 349. After that, 324. Next up, 258. Next up, 328. After that, watch this. Watch this. This is what I'm talking about. 274. 175. He's the one that helped me during the live auction. After that, 216. 100% participation at this table. 261. 261 just made a $100 gift. After that, 352. After that, 143. Next up, oh, she got two hands up. 182. 124. Yeah, you can give a round of applause. Sorry about that. Watch this. 260. 262. Now, sir, I'm going to use you as an example in just a minute, so you keep yours handy, okay? I can tell you can handle it. Is there, 322. 322. Thank you very much. After that, 307. Watch this. Watch this. 228. 228. I see you. You can put your card down. Watch this crazy table. Watch this. Woo-wee. I done got hot. Watch this. Get them up. 133. 133. 310. 194 gives again. Ladies and gentlemen, 100% participation at this table tonight. Is there anybody else that can help us out? $100 donation. Anybody else? All right, I want y'all to stick with me for just a second. At the count of three, shush yourselves. One, two, three. Did you get another one back there? At the count of three. One, two, three. Watch. I want you to record 280 as the last $100 gift. Now, I want you all to give yourselves a round of applause. You are all heroes, heroes, for those that we serve at Chris 180. Now, I do believe that you are all heroes. However, you, sir, 280, if and only if we were to stop the giving right now, you, sir, would be considered our last hero. I do believe we're all heroes for Chris 180 tonight and the families and the children that we serve in our community. However, you would be considered our last hero. Now, if and only if he is, in fact, the last hero, well, the official last hero tonight is going to get a bourbon tasting for 10 at American Spirit Works inside the venue we are at right now. Private bourbon tasting for 10 at American Spirit Works. And you're also going to get a Falcons helmet signed by Grady Jarrett. Did you hear me? Did you hear me? So right now, you would be considered our last hero. Now, if anybody else would like to make a $100 donation, you could certainly be deemed the last hero. So I don't know. Watch this. Now watch. Sir, for just a second, you were the last hero. But now, bidder number 260 is the last hero. Now I want you to watch this. And you're going to repeat after me. Every time I raise my card, I am giving. I want you to say that with me. Every time I raise my card, I am giving. So you just raised your card at $100. You are going to get the private tasting for 10. You are going to get the signed Falcons helmet. When I say the D in sold, the last hero game is over. Is there anybody else that would like to be the last hero? Going once, going twice, third and final call. 264. 264 is now in the lead. But that didn't last very long because now number 276 is in the lead. 276. Now, every time you raise your card, you are giving. I will also say, when you stick your card up, it has to stay up. Is there anybody else? Did you get one back there? 105 is now in the lead. 105 is now in the lead. Is there anybody else? Going once, going twice. 272 is now in the lead. 272 is now in the lead. And after that, 293. 293 just made a $100 donation. Now, watch this. He was our last hero. He raised his card once at 100. He raised his card again at 100. That means every time he raises his card, he is giving. That means you raise your card once for 100. You raise it again for 100. Now it's $200. I think we can all agree this game could last all night long. Now it takes $200 if you want to be the last hero. $200 is what we're recording. When you raise your paddle up, you are giving $200. You are currently the last hero. You were the first last hero. Is there anybody else? Going once, going twice, third and final call, and I... So 265 is now in the lead with a $200 gift. $200 gift, 265. Is there anybody else? Did you get a 264? 264. I need somebody, Shoshana, I need somebody to assign this man a number real quick because I got to have a number so he could play. Just real quick. Somebody, nobody at your table let you borrow one? Are you in debt to them? How do You're going to be number one. You're in the lead now. Bidder number one just made a $200 gift. He's now watch this. Watch this. Watch this. 265. Everybody watch this. 265 just raised her card again at 200. Now listen to me, ma'am. Listen to me. You raised your card once at 200. You raised it again at 200. Now you're giving 400. This is only fair. I got to speed this up. We're raising money for Chris 180. Now it takes $500 if you want to be the last hero. I will not raise it again, but I'm going to tell you, You're going to get a bourbon tasting for 10 at American Spirit Works, and you're going to get a Falcons helmet signed by Grady Jarrett. $500 has been donated up front by bidder number 251. 251 is now the last hero. Is there anybody else? Going once, going twice, 280 just made a $500 gift. He is already in at $700 to be the last hero. Is there anybody else? Going once, going twice. Did you get it? Let me see it. $345, $500. $345. Is there anybody else? Going once, going twice. Third and final call, and I, bidder number one is back in the lead. Bidder number one is back in the lead. Is there anybody else? Going once, going twice. Third and final call, and I sold. There's no friends at this auction. 217 is in the lead, $500. 217. After that, 345 is now in the lead. 345. Is there anybody? Every time you raise your card, you are making a gift. Is there anybody else? Going once, going twice. Third and final call, and I sold. Oh. Sold it right back there. Sold, sold, sold. 345. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that brings the curtain down on the fundraising portion tonight. I want to thank you for your enthusiastic bidding, your extreme donations, your generosity. Thank you for supporting Chris 180. Thank you for your time and thank you for your attention. It's been my honor, my privilege, and my pleasure. My name is Trey Morris, once again from Murray, Kentucky, but it's also a privilege to introduce to you someone very important up to the stage. Now, you got 5 minutes left in the silent auction. We want you to keep buying those raffle tickets because somebody's taking home that Louis Vuitton purse. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Chris 180's president and CEO, Kathy Colbinson.
Thank you so much, Trey, and thanks to all of you for giving so generously here tonight. You are really changing lives. Thank you. It was an honor to sit there and witness your commitment to the work of Chris 180, and it is a much needed comfort to my soul. As you heard from Hazel and Rucia, and as so many of us know personally, sometimes life, simply put, is incredibly hard. In order to get through tough times, a strong network of support is necessary. And there is no one in this whole world who can truly do it alone. And as a young person with limited experience, this is especially true. The person who I'm honored to introduce tonight credits his mother for being that person for him. She guided him while he was a work in progress. And thanks to the love and support he received, he has impacted countless people. And I know that his legacy and his leadership will impact millions more. His generosity is grounded in this quote, "I expect to pass through this world but once. Any good, therefore, I can do, or any kindness that I can show to any fellow creature, let me do it now. Let me not defer or neglect it, for I shall not pass this way again." These words are from Arthur Blank's mother, Molly Blank. He will tell you that her compassion, generosity, and candor shaped his approach to leadership and philanthropy. Arthur is a visionary leader. He listens to those who are around him and ensures that his goals and value system undergird every decision he makes. From his hires, to his giving, to his bottom line. And that is why he brought on Rich McKay. Arthur knew that Rich not only is a strong leader, he's a person who shares his values, leads with integrity, and keeps a keen eye on the bottom line. Both of these incredible men have chosen Chris 180 as a beneficiary of their wisdom and generosity. Chris 180 aligns with their values, their focus on listening, and their caring for people and for communities, particularly for children and families. Both understand the critical importance of investment in mental health and well-being. They understand that the natural world is important to mental health. The work environment is important to mental health. And safe communities are important to mental health. They understand that people need to have permission and space for their feelings. And this understanding and commitment accelerates goal achievement. Arthur Blank and Rich McKay each understand this connection and value it in their work and in their philanthropy. This is visionary leadership. See it, address it, and empower people and communities to persevere through the hard times to build a brighter future. Arthur and Rich both know that mental health is a vital long-term investment necessary to create a better world. Arthur, we're so glad you chose Rich. Through your example every day, you demonstrate that goals can be reached without sacrificing values. You are an inspiration, and I'm excited to hear you tell us even more about Rich McKay. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming an incredible friend and inspiration to me and to Chris 180, Arthur Blank.
Welcome to Atlanta, jacking hammers and bows. Back to the Mackin' and jacking the clothes. Adolescents packing a bow. A knock on the door. Who is it?
Thank you, Kathy. This actually, I want to thank the auctioneer all the way from Nashville, or outside of Nashville. Did an incredible job. Give him another round of applause. I don't know if he's still here or not, but that's a long way to come for a special cause, so thank you. I've known Kathy for a very long period of time. This is really good because my notes aren't going to sit up here, so I'll just do this kind of without notes, which is okay. I first met Kathy probably well over 30 years ago. Where is Kathy now? Oh, right here, sweetheart. So I met Kathy when Chris 180 was actually Charlie, as I remember, right? And we have 8 homes now, I think. Is that correct? I remember we met visiting the first home and walked through the home along with you back in 1989, I think it was, something like that. And we were walking around the home, and then I remember going on the outside and standing on the corner of the house with you, and at that point I was blessed to have an opportunity to be starting Home Depot and having our early successes, et cetera. And our then foundation at the Home Depot made a commitment, and since then our family foundation has been incredibly supportive of Kathy, but really of the work that that Chris 180 does. So it's an honor for me here to be here tonight, anything related to Chris 180. There are some things, a lot of things I could tell you about Rich McKay. So one of which is a little bit shocking to me tonight, and that is, this is probably the only time I've ever seen Rich separated from his wife, is either in a business setting or on a golf course or smoking a cigar. So I'm not sure what this is about tonight. So all of these wonderful things that I'm going to say about Rich and Taryn as a family, and I see Hunter here tonight, and I know that John is here in spirit, I'm not sure, but we worked hard at trying to bring Rich to Atlanta. It's been 20 years. It has been a blessing, both professionally and personally, in every way. We're very fortunate to have his, professional counsel and guidance to me, to our football team, to all our sporting teams, to our leadership group, to our community involvement. And the other thing which you're seeing tonight, although they're not sitting together physically, they're together spiritually and in every other way, I know, is that a beautiful connection of a great American family, and that's the McKays. And I mean that sincerely. So, Taryn, when she came to Atlanta, she immediately got involved with community and was able to pick up our interest in CHRIST 180 and the work we were doing, et cetera, and committed herself, and she's been on the board, I don't know how many years. How many years, Taryn, has it been? Forever? For a very long period of time. So it's a beautiful thing because I see Taryn support Rich every single day in his work and his efforts, his community involvement, et cetera. And this is symbolic of the kind of magnificent family that they have, is that Rich is really here tonight. He's here being honored, but actually he's here being honored, honoring the work that Taryn and Kathy and everybody else is doing to support CHRIST 180. So I want to thank you, Rich, for all of your friendship, everything you've meant to me personally, and everything you mean to our family. Rich has been a great mentor to, I have six children. One of my favorite quotes is that your name and age, I have a child, and between that, my six grandchildren, that definitely is true. But Rich has been a great friend, a great supporter, and a great teacher to my two of my three sons, Joshua and Max. And so I really want to thank you for that, and thank you for all of your support of them, and your just support of everything that we believe in, all of our core values. CHRIST 180 does work that, and I think Kathy would agree with me on this. Today, we're living in the most difficult times when it comes to mental health and mental well-being. You can say, well, it's easy, you're saying that, you have a wonderful family foundation, we do great work, we care deeply about mental health and mental well-being, all that's true, but it's more important that you listen to the Surgeon General's reports. In May of this year, he issued two reports, and the Surgeon General doesn't issue reports every week, but two reports relative to the work that CHRIST 180 is doing. One of them is that for young people, this device that we all carry, and we all either have children, connected to children, grandchildren, other people have friends, et cetera. This device in the hands of kids who are under age 12 is very destructive, and has added tremendously to the pressures and the stress that young people are feeling. So I would encourage you in every ways you can, try to keep these devices out of the hands of our children or make sure their use is very limited. So that's the second thing, which the second report issued by the Surgeon General actually within the same month had to do trends in the United States since 1976, which was 3 years before we co-founded the Home Depot here in 79, is that the state of loneliness in this country is at an all-time high. So what does that mean? It's really connected to the first thing as well, because our young people, or even our adults, believe that this is what connects you. This actually connects you to a piece of plastic. It doesn't connect you to a human being. It doesn't connect you to somebody else's feelings, their emotions, their spirits, everything that drives us at our core to be the very best we can be. So, this notion of loneliness has, quadrupled rates of heart disease, cardiac disease, you name it, all of this contributes, and contributes at the end of the day to significant mental health and mental wellness issues that we have in this country. So, be connected, and that's really what a lot of the work that CHRIST 180 does, is being connected to other people, reaching out to other people, don't let people get lonely, spend time with them, pick up the phone, call them, visit with them, take them to dinner, take them to lunch, take them to Chick-fil-A other than Sundays. Do whatever you want to do, but spend some time, with other people. That connectiveness, that human connection is what separates us from every other species on the face of the earth. And that's the miracle of us being human beings. It gives us the ability to make a difference in the lives of other people that we are connected to. So, I feel so strongly about the beautiful work that, you know, Kathy's done for so many years, and that Rich, I can't thank you enough for all of your professional friendship, your professional support. Rich has not only been a great friend to my family, Rich is one of the trustees of my estate. So we don't have 100 trustees, a handful, and they're all like brothers to me. So Rich is more like a brother to me than a work partner, than associate and colleague. So I'm honored here to be here tonight with you, Rich, and I'm honored really to honor Taryn as well, who you've committed, you know, your work to support her work just the way she has done for so many years for yourself. So thank you for asking me to do this tonight. I don't know if you had anything to do with it. Maybe Taryn did. So thank you, Taryn, for asking me to do this tonight. It's a blessing for me. So God bless, Rich, coming up and receive your proper honor. Thank you.
Rich McKay, I'm the CEO of AMBSE and the Atlanta Falcons. I think CHRIS 180, their mission and everything they do is trying to be an advocate for people that don't have advocates.
I think it is really great that CHRIS 180 is recognizing Rich. He does what he does because he passionately cares. To use a football analogy, Rich is a cheerleader and a quarterback. He is a great ambassador for the mission and the work of CHRIS 180, and he orchestrates implementation.
Professional sports teams have tremendous platforms. We have resources. So people that have resources and platforms are obligated to do the right thing. And part of doing the right thing is to support organizations like CHRIS 180.
Rich is an incredible role model for the Falcon organization and for the players.
You know, you try to draft for character. When you draft good people, if they have good mentors, things will turn out well. So to have Tony Dungy, to have Dan Quinn, to have Arthur Smith, I mean, we've had a lot of people that have come through here that are really good mentors to our players, and that leads to them doing the right thing in the community.
He has provided inspiration, he has provided leadership, and he has provided an example for others to follow. I see Rich and Taryn as the quiet power couple who moves behind the scenes to make things happen.
She is fantastic for me in always getting me to do the right things when I need to do the right things, and CHRIS 180 is one of those. And so I don't certainly deserve any recognition for what I've done for CHRIS 180. She deserves all the recognition.
From inviting CHRIS 180 youth and families to games, to feeding thousands of people, I bet that this stadium could be completely full of people who have a connection that's meaningful with Rich McKay.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2023 CHRIStal Vision Award winner, Rich McKay.
Oh, I'm gonna. I get the award. I love that. Thank you. Okay. Now I'm gonna speak for 3 seconds because number one, this award, as Arthur notes and you all know, really belongs to my bride. This is when we came here in, whenever we got here. When did we get here, sweetheart? 20 years ago. First thing that Taryn did was go to Stephanie Blank and say, okay, where is the place that we can make the impact on youth? They said CHRIS 180, and that's where we went, and that's where she has been. So like many spouses in this room, I want all the credit, but I did none of the work. She literally did all the work. It just seems to be a usual thing, so thank you, sweetheart. You know, in life, you get fortunate to have mentors, so they were mentioned there. But when I think about the fact that Warwick Dunn, Tony Dungy, and Arthur Blank came into my life, those are three pretty good philanthropists. And so I just want to say thank you to those men for impacting me and making sure that I know that we're supposed to do the right thing. And then Terry and Arthur Smith are here tonight, our GM, our coach. And the one thing I said in there and I say all the time is, we have a huge platform. We can make an impact. We have a franchise that can do something. But if you don't have leadership that supports it, doesn't get done very much. So I thank both of you for being here tonight and both of you for supporting what we can do to make a difference in the community. So thank you. God bless you for supporting Chris 180. Arthur's mom had a saying that if you do the right thing for the right reasons and you live with the consequences, well, Chris 180 does the right thing for the right reasons and has incredible consequences. So thank you. God bless you. God bless Kathy. What Kathy's done for Chris 180, all of us together do not combine to what she has done for this incredible place. And so God bless you, Kathy. So thank you. Thanks for coming tonight. Appreciate it.
I'd be reluctant. I didn't realize that Stephanie is here tonight. So, and I talked about two of my six children, three of our combined children, our two boys. So she's been a great mentor and a great parent and a great partner for all these years. And so thank you for being tonight. And thank you for being supportive of Kathy and Chris 180 for many, many years. I know you have been. So didn't know you were here. I wanted to recognize you. So thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back our co-chairs for the Crystal Ball, Lori Chenault, April Estes, and Cyril Turner.
While we take pictures. It's all good. You're welcome. Rich, you're truly an inspiration. Thank you.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
I just want to say I got a lot of credit up here, but it takes a village. And I want to recognize the Chris 180 staff who are here. You please give them a round of applause. And the board, which you're going to hear from, and the chairs, but just always remember, it takes a village, and you're a part of that village, so thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming and supporting Chris 180 this evening and being part of our family. We're so thankful that you've been here with us.
Okay, and what you've been waiting for. You guys have been amazing. You've helped us come pretty close to our goal, but the night is still early. And the raffle is still open, so we can reach our goal. So far, we have raised over $660,000. Your generosity will go very, very far in our Atlanta community. We'd like to also thank Hazel, Rusha, and so many more for this evening. Please stay in touch and stay connected, and together we'll continue to change lives.
Let's continue this great night with dessert and dancing. Please join us over there. and we'll see you there next year at the 2024 CHRISTal Ball. Have a good evening. Thank you.